I have more than I need, so I'll just feast on you.
Over here, partner. All I found were these Reachmen stalking the pass. Decided they'd rather die than talk, so I obliged. They don't look like they're from Ice Reach, but they are wearing the Coven's medallions. Anyway, did you find the lodge? Kilcreath? The temple to Meridia? Why would the Ice Reach Coven target a local Daedra cult? Damn, we're running out of time. I'll head back to Solitude and try again to warn High King Svargrim. You go to Kilcreath Temple and alert Meridia's priests. I'll meet you there as soon as I can. You'll be going up against the Coven by yourself. Warn the priests. If there's an opportunity to safely stop or delay the ritual, by all means. But don't take any unnecessary chances. I still don't want to lose another partner. Good luck.
If you see a pretty bottle around, let me know. It talks, if that helps. Oh, thank you. I was worried that Master Dren had gotten lost when I went to get myself some stew. I guess I just forgot why I set the bottle down. I'll go and get it. As soon as I finish my stew. It's really good stew. That's good. A talking bottle makes me nervous and it sure made Master Dren crankier than normal. I'll bring it here and keep it safe with his other stuff. Don't worry.
We should throw dice for gold. Hold, my friend. A disaster has befallen Kilgreath Temple.
Didn't I send you to Solitude? This place isn't safe. The Ice Reach Coven performed a ritual and summoned one of those Harrow Storms. Now Kilgreath Temple is crawling with Harrow Fiends. I'm sorry, but you're too late. The Coven unleashed their unnatural Harrow Storm, and now the entire area is overrun by vampires and Harrow Fiends. Still, meeting you again is fortuitous. We worked well together before, and I could use your help. There may be survivors who could use your help. And if we can learn more about the ritual that summoned the Harrow Storm, we might be able to determine how to stop them. Or at the very least, we can figure out where they plan to strike next. I could use your help to examine the strange pikes erected around the temple. Harrow Fiends and vampires roam the area, making it difficult to get close. Hence the need for your assistance. You see, I'm not that confident in my combat prowess. Yes, thanks to you. They're investigating vampiric activity in another part of the region, and attempting to identify the vampire we saw talking to the witch matron. In the meantime, they left me to deal with my own investigation. I tracked remains stolen from a mass grave in Bankorai. Ancient vampire remains, to be exact, and werewolf remains as well. They were smuggled through Solitude to wind up in the hands of the Ice Reach Coven. Now I need to determine why. House Ravenwatch's resources are limited, and Skyrim is a big place. We operate alone or in groups as necessary, depending on the situation. My task is to track down the remains stolen from Bankorai, and determine what the Coven is doing with them. What we saw in the Barrow was a prototype of sorts. This Harrow Storm was far more powerful. The storm struck the temple, leaving vampires and Harrow Fiends in its wake. I still need to determine the exact mechanism of these storms.
priest of Meridia. Maybe they can tell us more about what happened at the temple.
Please, can anybody help us? Oh, thank Meridia! The priests and pilgrims of Kiltrith Temple. We need assistance. A great and terrible storm struck, and so many of us were lost. A temple dedicated to Meridia, the Lady of Light. Pilgrims come from across Skyrim to pray and seek blessings, especially at this time of the year. Please, talk to Priest Bavian. You'll find her in the nearby cave, tending to the injured. She's the ranking priest, after High Priest Varkor. But we haven't seen the High Priest since the storm hit. Bavian led a group of us to safety. There are more priests and pilgrims out there. If you're willing to help, please talk to Bavian.
The living take precedence. You should search for survivors while investigating the pikes. An alchemical residue. That should prove useful. Let's look for more witch pikes. The more I can learn, the better chance I have of understanding the nature of this ritual. The Ice Reach Coven performed a ritual that unleashed a harrow storm on the temple. It struck without warning and evaporated as quickly as it began. But in its wake, it left behind harrow fiends. Innocent priests and pilgrims transformed into monsters. That's what I heard the Ice Reach Coven call the storm that struck Kilcreath Temple. It's magical in nature, the result of some sort of ritual performed by the witches. I'm still investigating, but I think the Harrow Fiends are a byproduct of the storm. Let's look for more witch pikes. Hmph. look for more witch pipes. Just ordinary sticks and rope now. Interesting. Can you feel the lingering energy? That's Daedric, if I'm not mistaken. These depleted witch pikes expended a lot of power to summon the Harrowstorm. Now they're just ordinary sticks, but even in this state, they tell us much about the ritual that flowed through them. I'm sure now that the pikes play a significant role as focal points for the storm ritual. The prepared pikes are depleted as the ritual runs its course, but I sensed lingering energy, including a Daedric taint. And we found an intriguing residue. It's the remains of an alchemical poultice that was spread over the pikes. Smells like rotting fungus, doesn't it? With a little study, I should be able to identify each ingredient in its makeup. Then I can begin to understand the ritual. One other thing I want to check first. I noticed the pilgrims leading a cart away from the temple right before the storm. These depleted witch pikes expended a lot of power to summon. I'm sure now that the pikes play. It's the remains of an alchemical poultice that was spread over the pikes. Smells like rotting fungus. One other thing I want to check first. I noticed the pilgrims leading a cart away from the temple right before the storm hit. Coven members could have tried to slip away among the innocents. The cart should be along the road south of the temple.
Yeah.
strange. You're alive, but unresponsive. Check the crates and see if they contain the smuggled items. Did you find anything of interest in the crate? I can't believe anyone knowingly involved would have let themselves be exposed to the storm. Perhaps the pilgrims were tricked into transporting the crate. Or maybe it was slipped into their cart. Yes, of course. Though I fear what we may find there. The temple was clearly at the center of the storm. Regardless, there's still a lot we don't know about the effects of this ritual. Observing the target area could offer new insights.
Thank you.
These are temple priests and pilgrims. It seems the storm killed them. I'll need to perform more tests. But from what we've seen, I believe the storm affects mortals in three distinct ways. It kills them, transforms them into harrow fiends, or leaves them mindless. I suppose I'd say it harrowed those poor pilgrims. I want to learn more about the ritual, and how it produces the harrow storms. And I need to confirm my theories about the storm's effects. I'll start by examining the residue from the witch pike to identify the components used to power the ritual. My alchemical equipment. It's extremely fragile, so I left it in my pack. I hid it among a copse of trees once I saw all the vampires and herophines. Once I retrieve it, I can find a place to begin my analysis.
That's close enough, Leech.
Wait, wait! I'm not part of the coven!
Looks like I made it back just in time. This place is crawling with vampires, and that one was about to make a meal out of you. House Ravenwatch. I've heard of him, but he's a long way from Rivenspire. Well, if you're willing to trust a vampire, I suppose I can too. I spotted a coven witch. If we hurry, we might be able to catch her. On the cliff overlooking the temple, calls herself Sister Embrit. I was going to rush her, but I wanted to make sure you hadn't run afoul of any of these monsters first. No offense, Fen. Come on, if we're lucky, the witch is still up there.
Perhaps I could question the witch before you introduce her to your impressive axe blade?
They smear something on those pikes before the ritual. Makes me glad I don't need to breathe.
Not even Harold. It seems the ritual needs refinement.
Kill her before she can summon another storm.
Willing sacrifices? How nice!
Sacrifice? I'd rather give you my axe, witch.
No matter. I found something. This way?
Go with your vampire friend. I'm gonna look around here.
Do you see? These are the same as the urns smuggled from Bankrai. They didn't just shatter. They exploded. I can sense traces of magicka clinging to the shards that matched the energy used in the storm ritual. These other fragments, though. All this rubble scattered around didn't just come from these urns. The texture and patterns are different. They appear to have used the funerary dust in the urns to summon the Harrow Storms. But I'm not sure what was inside the larger vessels. Look at the shape of the fragments. They come from a hollow receptacle of some sort. Something at least as tall as you. Perhaps larger. Just another piece of the puzzle. Maybe when I analyze the witchpike residue, an answer will suggest itself. Thank you, but no. I try to avoid large population centers. The temptation. You understand. I'll find someplace nearby, but out of the way, where I can set up my equipment and work undisturbed. I'll send word when I have something to report. I met a clever woman who lives in the bog near Morthol. Old Mjolin's a dying breed among the Nords, a practitioner of the old magic. The locals both admire and fear her. If anyone can help me untangle the coven's ritual, it's her. Mjolin's experience with the old ways and reach magic make her ideally suited to assist me in this endeavor. She's the closest thing to an expert we're likely to find out here. At least one who doesn't want to feed our eyes to a harpy. Western Skyrim consists of three holds: Hafengar, Hjalmarch, and Karthald. Morthol is the capital of Hjalmarch. It's located southeast of Solitude, along the river Hjal. Old Mjolin lives in the marshlands nearby. The Raven Watch has had to curtail rogue vampire clans, and put down feral blood fiends on occasion. But I've never dealt with anything like this before. People turning into harrow fiends, or becoming mindless harrowed. It's a nightmare. Yes, but more research is required to confirm anything. Still, from what we observed here, it appears the Harrow Storm produced three distinct results in those caught within it. It turned them into Harrow Fiends, or Harrowed, or it simply killed them.
So, what did your vampire friend discover? Reach witches summoning magical storms to create feral vampires? That's horrible, but to what purpose? Well, that's the next puzzle to solve. First, we need to get this information to the Queen. Here. This was for Brondolk, but it's yours now. Queen Gerhild needs to hear what we discovered at Kilcreath Temple. Hopefully that will be enough for her to get us an audience with High King Svargrim. The Queen seemed reasonable. She'll believe us. As for Svargrim, who can tell? I haven't met the man, but everything I've heard describes him as prideful, arrogant, and hard-headed. Even with the Queen's help, there's no guarantee. I'd like to knock down the palace door, grab him by the throat, and shake him until he listens. That would probably start a war, though, and Yoren specifically asked me to avoid that. For now, let's bring our evidence to Queen Gerhild. If there's anything else we need to discuss, let's get it out of the way now, before we return to Solitude. Hey, you and Fenorian came to that conclusion, not me. Still, it makes as much sense as anything. As to why, I have no idea. This connection to vampires, though, that's troubling. We should keep Fen away until we get into Svargrim's good graces. A clever woman? Out here? Nords are extremely distrustful of magic, especially Nords from Western Skyrim. I'm surprised the people of Morthal tolerate her presence. If anyone can help Fen figure out the Coven's ritual, though, it would be her. Our priority remains getting an audience with High King Svargrim. We need to convince him that the Ice Reach Coven is a threat to his kingdom, and get him to help us stop them. Let's return to Solitude and present our findings to the Queen. Clever men and women are Nords with an aptitude for magic, though most use the term to refer to practitioners of the old ways. They're rare. Not the usual adepts found at the Mages Guild. Distrust of magic runs deep in Skyrim, especially out here. Could be that the elves our ancestors fought soured our taste for magic. Or maybe there weren't enough skalds singing about wizards going to Sovngarde. Might be that Nords just prefer their natural talents. Either way, magic isn't popular here.
Yeah! Yeah!